I walk towards Fort Siloso on dull red cobblestones, which lie as allusions to blood spilt on thirsty soil, coagulated into a pathway under the symmetrical gaze of replica cannons standing guard. Built by the British to safeguard coal from Keppel Harbour, it was turned into a POW camp for Japanese conquerors. Now, it's a front for heritage. Pulau Belakang Mati, death from behind. Or is it Sentosa Island? Tranquility by popular demand. From prison to paradise seems to be a predominant theme over here. And all that's left of those tortured voices choking on bayonets is a menagerie of heroic mannequins. A picture of artillery tells the tale of failed tactics, with guns that couldn't even turn to meet the enemy.
The guns could always move, but what good are they against infantry? No, no, my dear, they could turn, but weren't worth turning.
From jungle wasteland to theme park heaven. Finally, industry is thriving over here. Resorts are springing up everywhere. It's a happy place. I guess it's time development reclaims the ruins of the past.
Those ruins are the vestiges of our history.
At last, we'll begin to make our memories. A new history that's created amongst the glint of roller coaster metal and, unfortunately, underpaid welders. The next generation will see no decay, only tropical glam and beachside margaritas. This is good. It is progression, a necessity.
I suppose you are right. We have to move forward. Break with tradition.
Modern era colonialist reproduction speaks of an old British pulse that stopped beating. It did, however, leave a shell for the next generation to pick up, to transform. Mansion cum hotel for the rich once again. But who can remember the lord that once lived atop this hill? I certainly cannot.
I lived and worked here in 1938 as a gardener. Oh my, they've changed the trees. My favorite trees, they never did like to be pruned. They'd much rather stretch their branches towards the sky. The lady of the house used to sit right there where you are and read. What was it? Kipling? Austin? The governor and his family had to leave, of course, after the surrender. But by that time, I was engaged elsewhere.
This is progress.
There's that word again.
If you want to create something fresh, then you must start from the rubble up.
Rubble is a mysterious thing.
Oh, hi, Auntie. I didn't see you there.
Well, sometimes the greatest discoveries fall from the trees. You're interested in history, I take it?
Yes. How do you know?
Never mind, my dear. If you want some history, just follow me.
Wow. Really?
Yes, come along.
Okay, sure.
Serendipity happens when the inquisitive mind becomes attuned to its search and develops a magnetism for opportunity. All it takes after that is the spirit of adventure.
Your house?
Yes, once upon a time. But it was much prettier, of course, when it was being used. I remember the smell of Chinese roses every time I passed through these gates to run errands. There was a lot more traffic back then, if you can imagine, and the gates were burnished every week. But time takes its toll. It was the Sultan who lived here, you know.
A sultan? Really?
Yes. Oh, yes. It was the Sultan of Johor, one of the richest men in the world at that time. He spent most of his time in Europe. But of course, there were many guests that stayed over. And he had many family members, many children. The old mansion is down this path. Not much further, my dear. was an errand girl and a kitchen hand. My mother was one of the many servants, so I helped by doing whatever jobs needed doing, really. These walls were so decadent before, washed to a glimmering perfection. The land was nicely tended as well, not this muddy mess you see everywhere. Over there is where I stayed.
So this is the servants' quarters?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Wow, is that your room?
I lived here for many years with my mother and sister. We used to play five stones in that corner. It was our favorite game. We didn't have much, but we were happy. All the servants lived here, and there was always laughter in this part of the mansion. I used to steal all sorts.